did not have a bride. Oh, he sighed, alas, and he pined, alas. But alas, the prince couldn't find a lass who would suit his mother's pride. For a princess is a delicate thing, delicate and dainty as a dragonfly's wing. You can recognize a lady by her elegant air. But a genuine princess is exceedingly rare. On a stormy night to the castle door came the lass the prince had been waiting for. "I'm a princess lost," quoth she. But the queen was cool and remained aloof, and she said, "Perhaps, but we'll need some proof. I'll prepare a test and see. I will test her thus," the old queen said. "I'll place 20 downy mattresses upon her bed, and beneath those 20 mattresses I'll place one tiny pea. If that pea disturbs her slumber, then a true princess is she." Now the bed was soft and extremely tall, but the dainty lass didn't sleep at all, and she told them so next day. Said the queen, "My dear, if you felt that pee, then we've proved enough of your royalty. Let the wedding music play." And the people shouted quietly, "A princess is a delicate thing, delicate and dainty as a dragonfly's wing. You can recognize a lady by her elegant air. But a genuine princess is exceedingly versions of this story. I sing them all. This is the prettiest, but it's not quite accurate. I happen to know the true story of the princess and the pea, for the very good reason that I was there. It was a small kingdom ruled over by a talkative queen and a mute king. The princess of the true story was not the only girl put to the test. Actually, she was one of 13 girls. Girls who came to the castle hoping to wed the prince, but who, for one reason or another, were found to be unsuitable. As a matter of fact, the day I arrived at court, they were testing princess number 12. A curious quiz was in progress.